Hello everybody, I'm Andrea Lanussi and I'm here today to show one of the new features in Delphi and C++ Builder 2010. Let's start looking one of the new features on the IDE. As you can see here, the file reopened, we have a new menu item defined as properties. Here you can define the number of projects and files that should be listed on the menu file reopen. Also, I can delete the files already on this list, or I can delete the non-existing files. It's really a useful feature that can allow you to manage this list. Another really cool feature in the RAD Studio 2010 is the IDE Insight. With the IDE Insight, you can search for every single option on the IDE. For example, if I type here VCL, I have here the whole options available to create applications, to create components, or change the configurations related with the VCL. For example, if I just double click here, VCL forms application, I'm creating my application. If you have another project open and you type F6 and you type, for example, debug, what you see here is the options related with the debug word. I can run application without debug, I can set the debug desktop configuration, or, for example, I can change the preference on the debug. If I double-click, it moves directly for this option on the tools options. I just type and click once. I don't have to go click, click, click all the time to find those information. Another really cool feature in RAD Studio 2010 for Delphi and C++ developers is the source code formatter. With the source code formatter, you can format your code based on a bunch of configurations you can define on the IDE. To change this configuration, to see these configurations, let's invoke the IDE Insight type formatter. And here I have a bunch of options I can change to define my format. Here we have the options for C++ language and for Delphi language. Let's go and change the option line breaks and use clause to yes. And let's invoke the format source option here. As you can see, I have one users per line here because I changed this option in the IDE. You have a lot of different options you can define and you can add and change anytime. This is a really cool feature that's going to help you and your team to have a standard format in your source code. Let's move forward with one of the new features on RAD Studio 2010. This new feature is related with the component toolbar. A lot of developers that still using Delphi 7 and C++ Builder 6, they love the component toolbar here on the top. Now, in the RAD Studio 2010, you just right-click in the main toolbar and click on component, and it's here. The old component toolbar is back. You can navigate through the components. You can right-click if you have a lot of components installed in IDE. This option here is much easier for you to navigate through the components. Also, you have the search box that allow you to search for specific components by name. As you can see here, I'm filtering just all components related with label. Okay, this new toolbar is completely independent of the old toolbar is completely independent of the new toolbar. Here I can search for a different set of components. You can work with both. You can work with just one, whatever you want. It's your decision. Okay, let's see another new feature in the IDE. This new feature is related with the build process. I'm gonna open my C++ builder, C++ project, okay? And when you compile the project today, before Delphi 2010, RAD Studio 2010, you have to wait the compile to finish the process, to do any other thing. You cannot work at the same time the IDE is in build process. Now, we have a new feature named background compilation. As you can see here, I'm using the IDE Insight to find this option. I can enable this option here, compile again the project. Let me clean the project first. And now I can open and do whatever I wanna, add the new breakpoints here, during the build process. Also, I know you don't want to see this window all the time because you want to work, you want more space, you want a clean environment. Then you can back on the IDE side and go on the show compile process, show compile progress, and deactivate this option. At the moment we deactivate this option, you have the same behavior that old versions. All compile message is going to be on the message window. Here, I can work it, change my code, do whatever I want. What is happening if you change your code during the build process? Don't worry about that, because the IDE takes a snapshot at the moment you start the build process, okay? And all changes you make after the build start is not going to be considered for the compiler. As you can see, the background compilation can help you to make more, to be more productive, and to keep working during the build process. You don't need to wait anything. You don't need to wait the IDE to finish this process. Well, I hope you enjoy these new features in RAD Studio 2010 for Delphi and C++ developers. I let you hear. If you want to know more about what's coming, this new release, go through our blog website, blogs.embarcadero.com, and there's a lot of stuff coming on, and we are posting every day new informations and new features in RAD Studio 2010. Thank you for your time. See you in the next video.